gently be creating a body that functions at a high level, that's healthy on the inside, with the strength, with the balance, with the flexibility, and also the endurance, so that our bodies become strong. Nice and relaxed, you're just going to gently lie back in this position. And we're going to take a deep breath in, hands go above our heads, stretching up, stretching nice and tall, stretching those hands away from the feet. And as we exhale, our right leg comes into the body and hug that leg. And with your left hand, pull that knee across the body, keeping the feet and knee about 6 inches off the ground. Enjoy stretching out the body. And inhale, bring it up to the center. Exhale, take it out to the other side. Feet are flexed. Base leg is strong and rooted into the ground. Lower back pushed into the ground. And inhale, bring it up to the center. And just hug that leg. Lift up the chin. Place that chin on the knee. And just gently let that leg go back to the other leg. Inhale, hands go up. Deep breath in, and as we exhale, left leg comes into the chest, and we hug that leg. Hugging that leg like you would hug a loved one. Remember, we want to get into that state of just being loved, because that's ultimately who we are when we're at our best. And take that leg across the body. Nice and relaxed, not forcing anything. And inhale, bring it up to the center. Exhale, take it out to the other side. Good. And inhale, bring it to the center. And lift up chin, place the chin on the knee. And gently place that leg next to the other leg. Good. Inhale. Both knees come up with our arms now spread to the sides. And as we exhale, we gently let our knees fall out to the left hand side. Knees together, feet together. Knees and feet about 6 inches off the ground. It should be an arch in your lower back, activating the spine. And inhale, bring it up to the center. Exhale, we take it over to the other side. And inhale, back to the center. Hugging both legs and lifting your chin up, placing your chin on your knees. Good. And legs gently come back. Inhale, we take a deep breath in. And as we exhale, we just roll over on one side and just come up to all fours. Good. Nice and relaxed. Relaxed mind, relaxed body, up on all fours. And we're just going to gently do some circles around those wrists, warming those wrists up, letting those wrists know that we're actually going to be doing some balances on them, and change direction, making sure the wrists are nice and warm. And now do the same with the hands pointing outwards, circles around, and change direction. Nice and easy. Now your fingers pointing back to you. Same thing, keep those circles going. Being relaxed. If there's any tension, great. Breathe into the tension and change directions. Okay, and hands come back. Just move them forward, toes go under. And we just go back to a bent leg, downward dog. And in this position, all we're going to do is start to press out those heels one at a time. Just releasing the tension in the lower legs. One leg, then the other. And then we take a nice deep breath in. And as you breathe in, right leg comes forward for pigeon run. Inhale, all the way up. Looking up, and as you look up, eyes are relaxed, throat muscles are relaxed, forehead relaxed, everything is relaxed. And as you exhale, come forward. Hands stretched all the way out in front. Fingertips slightly off the floor. Forehead just completely relaxed on the mat. And surrender in this position. Remember, breathing is always the focus of yoga and any meditation. Breathing in the belly. Good. Hands come back. You look all the way up again. Fat toe comes under. And we go back to downward dog. And inhale. And left leg comes forward to pigeon run. Inhale, we look up. And we just take the glide forwards, surrendering in each position. In this position, completely let everything go. And remember, the deeper the relaxation, the deeper the feeling. In this position, take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, just feel the body relax in this position. Just let it all go. Let every muscle just relax even deeper. And come back. Lift up again. Toe goes under. And we go back to downward dog. Good. And in this position, we're going to walk or jump to a cross-legged position. Legs move forward. Nice and strong, rooted into the ground. Back nice and straight. Slight arch in the lower back. None of this. Completely changes how your body communicates to you. You want energy flowing through you. A good, positive energy, life force energy flowing through that body. Inhale, hands go up. And as we exhale, we're going to take our right leg under the left leg. Pull that leg all the way over. So right leg goes under the left leg. Listen to the directions and your left leg comes beside the knee. Right arm goes across the body, and we turn around, and we just gently look behind. And the reason we're twisting is because we're helping the body detox. Any twisting yoga is like wringing out a dirty cloth. We're getting rid of the toxins, we're getting rid of the poisons. We live in a toxic world nowadays, and we have to do as much as we can to keep cleansing and detoxing, so the body doesn't get clogged up with these poisons. Remember, breathing deeply is the key. Breathing deep into that diaphragm, and over time you exhale, you just relax and twist a little bit further to breathe in. And as we exhale, we relax, but we find ourselves twisting slightly further. Let me come back to the center, and then we're going to switch legs. in the same position, just on the other side. So inhale, and as you exhale, you just gently twist even further. And every time you exhale, just twist in slightly further. Come back to the center. Right. Inhale, hands go up. And as we exhale, we're going to cross our legs under the body. Hands come forward. And we just gently go back to downward dog. Eyes are relaxed. Hands push forwards and upwards. Sit bones towards the sky. Slight arch in that lower back to activate those hamstrings so you can breathe into them and then let them relax. Good. And right leg comes forward. Left leg comes forward. And then we take a deep breath in all the way up. And we come back to prayer position. Now while we're in this position, we always go to love. Our hands are towards our hearts, simply accessing that frequency of love. What could you focus on now that would fill you up with love? Somebody, something, what could you send love to, or who could you send love to in this moment? Breathing your love into your body. Understanding that we live in a vibrational world. And the easiest way to raise your vibrational set point is to simply focus on love. Giving love to 100 trillion cells in your body. Allowing them to thrive with life. Inhale, hands go up. And as you exhale, you go down with a flat back, all the way down to as far as you can go, where it's comfortable, not forcing anything, but go to wherever the tension is, breathe into the tension, and then as you exhale, you're just going to allow the body just to relax even more in this position, finding yourself relaxing as you get closer to the floor, until they're eventually on the floor. So take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, you just allow yourself to relax into the stretch, mastering the art of relaxation. Inhale again. And as you exhale, just allow the body to relax. You don't have to force anything. We're relaxing into these positions. If you force it, you can tear a muscle, pull a muscle, we're just relaxing. One more deep breath in, and as we exhale, we find our hands and fingers just getting another millimeter or centimeter closer to the floor. Good, and from this position, hands go down, and we're going to walk or jump back to a push-up position. Inhale, so upward dog, relaxing the lower back. Toes are going to go under, and now we're just going to start to flow. So we're going to do three of these, and we're not going to stop moving. So we're going to gently go back to downward dog. As we go back, our knees come down, chin brushes across the floor, all the way forwards to upward dog. Toes go under, and we go back to downward dog. Knees come down, all the way forwards. And we go back very daunting. You get it flowing, you get it moving, all the way forwards, to up the dog, and then all the way back to down. And from this position, we're going to go straight into the side balances to the left, and again, choose which one works for you. You can go with the basic one, and you want to be in perfect alignment, perfect straight line. So just choose which one works for you. Whether you want to go 2 feet together, you want to take it advanced, put one leg up, or if you want to go even more advanced, you're going to hook that toe in and lift it up. Always keep pushing yourself. We're getting back in the body. We're letting the body do the balancing here. The mind is out of the game. Good. And come back down again. Well done. We go back to downward dog. And breathe in this position. Keep breathing deeply into the belly. Relax eyes, relax forehead. Everything's relaxed in the body. Now see yourself doing the balance that you want on the other side. Which do you want to go for? Do you want to do basic, advanced? Where do you want to go? See yourself doing it now. Visualize it in your mind. See yourself already doing it. See yourself doing it and enjoying it and doing it with ease. Good. And then go straight into that balance. And be confident, be strong. Feel it. Not stressing anything. Finding that balance. Solid. Good. Very good. And we come back. And then we go back to child pose. And we're going to rest our head on the floor and surrender in this position. Good. And while you're relaxed in this position, again, see yourself in the ice bath. See yourself feeling relaxed. Take a deep breath in and get used to that feeling of relaxation, surrendering. How can you let go of any tension? How can you release the mind so that you completely give yourself back to the body? Feel into the body, take one more deep breath in, and then just relax, mastering the art of relaxation. We live very busy, very stressful lives nowadays, and we need to master the art of relaxation. Remember, the more we relax, the more we heal. Stress is the biggest killer. Doesn't matter what the stress is, whether it's mental, emotional, physical, environmental, from relationships, from toxins and poisons, from the air, from the foods. All of this stress is coming in. So we need to master ourselves, so that no matter what's going on, we can go to a deep place of relaxation. We're going to do it one more time. Take a deep breath in. Now, tense the body in this position. It might feel weird, but tense the body. Tense the facial muscles. Tense your hands. Tense your feet. Tense your legs. Tense your stomach. Tense everything. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And then 1, 2, 3, let it go. Relax even deeper in this position. And see yourself in the ice bath, relaxed with this feeling. Trust it. And there's actually a part of you that's very excited about the ice bath. It's going to be an incredible teacher. It's going to teach us so much. We're allowing ice to become an invaluable teacher. Today we learn so much. From this position, we're just going to gently come up. Just walk to a basic cross-legged position. And go up. Hands come down, and our right hand goes in front. And we're just going to simply twist. Yeah. Not forcing anything. And gently eyes come back to the front and turn into position. Yeah. Hands come forward. We can very quickly access the warrior part of us. We're going to need strength today. So we're going to go back to downward dog. On this position, we're either going to walk or jump our feet between our hands. Inhale, hands come up. All the way down, a nice flat back. Hands go down, and from here, our left leg is going to come back to a lunge. Fingertips down, all the way up to warrior one. Stretching up nice and tall, arms straight, pulling up through the body. Hands go down, everything perfectly straight. And you slide all the way back. And all the way forward, feeling that peacefulness of a warrior. And then fingertips come down again. Back up. Move forward then. Noticing the body is getting stronger and it's getting more flexible. And from here, other leg comes back. Move all the way up. Nice and straight. Legs are activated. Pulling up through the core. Hands go down. And from your fingers, looking past your fingers with that endless gaze, like a warrior, feeling your strength, feeling your power, bringing that strength and power with you today, and it's always there to access when you need it, gliding all the way back. Yeah. Looking at your face foot, and then changing your focus to your top hand, but keeping your balance, letting the body do the balance. And back, hands come all the way forward, stretching nice and tall and strong, bring it back down to runner's pose. And in the back push-up position, all the way to upward dog. Toes go under, we go back, downward dog, and from here we're going to jump our feet between our hands again if you can. Good. Inhale all the way up, and come back to prayer position, feeling alive, feeling activated, but feeling calm at the same time, ready for a day that is going to be jam-packed full of breakthroughs. Feeling that sense of excitement, that sense of wonder, like something magical is going to happen today, and it is. In the state of being, sending love out to those that you care about, sending love out to those that you don't even know yet that you're going to be caring about. And in fact, just sending love out to anyone who you've ever come in contact with that might need it. and you love yourself as well. Knowing that today is going to be a great day. And on that note, namaste. Thank you very much. Give yourself a round of applause, everyone. Well done. Good job. So now we're going to get right off. We're going to go back in there, get our bits, and then we're going to be walking over. We're going to go through a few little bits in there. We're going to be walking over, and it's prep time for the ice bath. Well done.
And I've got a question for you. Have you ever felt in life where life has beaten you up? Have you ever felt in despair? Have you ever felt alone? Have you ever felt like a victim? Have you ever felt ill? If you felt any of these things, all it's showing you is that there's more things to learn in life.